Good evening and welcome back everybody. Gonna be streaming a bit more Returnal today. Streamed it around about a week ago and did put the VODs on YouTube in two parts. I've been playing a little bit in the background as well, just to practice a bit and get to grip with some of the mechanics. The first stream I did was literally the first time I played it, so yeah, we're just going to jump in. The main reason today is, again, just to get more familiar with the game, but also to see if we can beat Frike, who is the first boss. Let's get used to the controls again. Okay. But massively been enjoying the game. Try not to spoil too much of it by looking into to sort of guides and tips and things like that. Just been trying to get to grips with it myself. I have seen a couple of things that are useful. Just for example, not really using ether on... where am I even going here? Yeah, it seems like ether is pretty key, so you don't really want to spend that unless sort of necessary. You want to sort of save it up. Okay. Also, what I've been trying to do is get to grips with the overload function, which I can see I missed there, but... Damn, took a hit. This just probably wasn't the best start to go into basically a mini-boss. And I've got no... That was poor. Got no upgrades or anything yet. Bad, not bad. Yes, we'll take that upgrade. That was a quick start. And we'll go into the triangle door. Necessary hits there. Right. Ooh, interesting. What is this?
There are strange psychological encounters I've had with what can only be described as visual echoes of previous deaths. At first I avoided them, but I needed to know. When
Okay, so we found the secret door. And let's just pick up any items that we can. Get up there. Nice. It's not a bad room to start with. Last shell. Sunrose barrel. Leave that one for now. Let's try this one. That's definitely better. Ooh. No, let's stick with Sidon for now. Tell you what, just whilst I'm doing this. Just give me 2 moments. I'm just gonna where am I? Just have a quick look at this. Just gonna send out a tweet as well. Yeah, but like I said, I've been really enjoying this game. Just been playing bits and pieces. I have been busy at work this week, but it's a game you can easily get lost in, think I'll just play sort of one run, and then before you know it, you know 2 or 3 hours into the game. Don't think I can get up there. No, still haven't unlocked whatever that's going to be yet, that orange thing, some sort of, don't know if it's going to be like a hook shot of some sort, or hang on, now we did have. Yeah, let's go back over here. Because we did have a door we couldn't get through before. Sorry, not a door we couldn't get through. We couldn't open the actual chest. Okay. Okay, so having a malfunction would be beneficial. Interesting. Yeah, one thing I've learned, I think I used a fair bit of ether in my first playthrough, just taking away malignancy and malfunctions and things like that. But I think it's best to not use it. Okay. I see ya. Almost. The reason why I haven't taken them down to kill them from afar is so I can get the blights. Because they do disappear quite quick. and I think playing it safe can backfire in the long run. Can't go on water yet, again I don't know how to do that. There's a door here again, I can't get over there. Okay. And obviously if anyone's got any tips, sort of spoiler-free tips, I suppose, I'm happy to listen to them and hear them. Yeah, just absolutely brilliant game. Again, I haven't played too much of it so far. Let's see what this is. I haven't been that keen on the shotgun so far, so probably one that I have to get used to. And I know there are benefits for trying out all the different weapons because you can sort of upgrade them. Okay, so there's a door over here. What's this? One. Okay, we're gonna take that. Didn't actually get a malignancy in that one. But remember, we have got an artifact which gives us 10% more damage if we do happen to get a malfunction, so it's not the worst thing. Doors, I think there's normally a button you can shoot somewhere. Let's see if we can see it. Ah! So again, just learning. Blast shell. That could be useful. Narrow mole. Do you know what? Why don't I just try it? Get used to it. Still not convinced that the shotguns are the best, but which way do I want to go? I think I don't know if this could be bad to go through with this one, but is there anything? No. I think this is a place I can't go anyway. Yep, so you need some sort of key or device to unlock that. Okay, right, let's go this way. Now, you've got to be sometimes a bit quick when you teleport because things can spawn. I mean, it goes without saying that shotguns should be extremely effective. Jumps create energy blast on landing. I mean, we'll take it because we haven't got a consumable. Yeah, but it goes without saying that your shotguns would be powerful at close range, but that was very powerful. Ooh, Nelly. I hate these guys. Few hits there. there's another guy somewhere. So that wasn't as clean as the other attempts, but not too bad, because those Groot looking guys can be pretty tough. Right, what's going to happen here? Now he's heading over there, I'm going to get this health. Right. I'll just take it. This could be bad. Where am I? Where is it? Oh god. I don't really want to cheese it, but make sure I don't fall as well. Ideally, I want to be close when I kill him. Yes. This is a good run so far. No more. Nope, I think we'll keep the one we've got. Very similar. Oops. So, I did see another piece of health somewhere. Where is it? This here. Where is it? I'm gonna just drop off. It's underneath there, is it? Ah, literally right here. Okay. Whoops. I was severely wrong about the shotgun type weapons. Right, let's go up here, get health. I do like how the mechanic of health, that even if you've got full health, going for them is a good thing because it increases the capacity. I think that's a really good mechanic. Right, we're going in the right way. Now, the only thing I would say, I'm not sure the shotgun will be great for Frike, assuming we actually get that far. I've got the house here. Now, I've been in the house once. I don't know if you can... I'm assuming you can go in again, can you? Inaccessible. Maybe it unlocks again later in the story. device that exchanges ether and obelisk for one another, it seems poised to do something. So this is like anyone that's playing Returnal. Well, let's not exchange them yet. Let's see. Is there anything that I want to get? Astronaut. Melee key, generate two energy bolts that hit two nearest hostiles. That seems really useful. But for Frike, maybe not so much. Now, is the astronaut, I think it's, is that like a respawn, like a one, like a do-over? I'm not sure. Because I could get the astronaut, but that leaves with me only, well, just under 100. Could get melee kills. Increase speed and protection, that would be good as well. I'm going to try the astronaut. Because I've heard about it, but I don't know exactly what it does. Yeah, now I haven't got enough. So that's fine. There's another glyph here. It's got a trophy. Okay. Now, how far does it look like we are? It doesn't look like we've got too much more to go until we can potentially face Frike. See that. Too busy focusing on this guy. Thanks. Just give me 2 moments here. It's fine though, it's fine. What's this? Blast shell. Now, I think we'll want to take this now simply because Frike will be up and coming, and I think, although I haven't beaten so far, it's probably one that having that distance is key. Faced him a couple of times, very close to beating him the last time. Special for this. Ooh, nice. Let's just have a quick look what the okay, so there should be health in here. And Mountains. Can we get up there? Yes. So, probably try and go through. Ah, there's another one of these. So these will be functions, I think. So, fills one slot, okay. Two slots, that's much better anyway. One slot. Two slots, are these all the same, basically? Fixes or prevents one malfunction, detaches afterwards. We don't have any malfunctions yet. One slot. Do you know what? We're just gonna take that. That was pretty good. I think we're looking pretty good so far. And now if we can get a button. Ooh. Bonus damage is good. Shock stream's really good as well. Yeah. I mean, I'm saying this thing like another game Inside Out. I certainly don't know. Oh shit, is this one of these ones where I need to... Yeah. They heal enemies, don't they? Get some space. Damn. What the hell? There's another one. I did not know that. This is all going terribly wrong. It's going so well. I didn't make that either. Okay, so Astronaut is a respawn, which is what I thought it was. I was hoping it would be for the boss though. Was unfortunate. Has done so well. And there's not really any health around here. Right, let's hope the next place has some health pickups and not a lockdown. Really need to get these health. And these guys just get stuck. Damn. Yeah, what's disappointing is that probably that first 20 minutes or so was probably the cleanest one I've had so far. And I felt like we're in a good position if we got to Frike that we'll at least get close to beating him. Now what we want to do is deposit some ether. Take it, but yeah, apparently depositing ether in here obviously gets you an item, but it also unlocks item to find in the game as well. That's what I've heard. So best to use ether for that. Now if that's wrong or if that's true, but there's other ways that are good to use it as well, let me know. This obviously this video will be going on YouTube. It's live at the moment on Twitch, but we'll be looking to upload the VODs as normal. It's like those group tree looking guys that I struggle with, because they do slow you down, they're pretty powerful. What's in here? Ah, this room. Okay, I remember this room. Is this? That's fine. So I believe there's a chest here, yeah. We'll take the carbine. We'll take the slightly upgraded carbine. Yeah, I'm taking that. Yeah, can't get over there yet. I wonder if I break this. Oh, that does actually get you lights. So watch out for the glowing eyes of those guys. Got a few orb lights in. Whoops. Clearly was not watching where I'm going. So it's the 5th of March today and I just finished recording the last episode of my Resident Evil 4 playthrough last night. Haven't edited it yet. This is the original Resident Evil 4. So there'll be an episode coming out tonight on Sunday at 8 PM UK time. Another episode next Sunday. And then on the 19th, that will be the final episode of that playthrough. Really enjoyed it. I've completed that game more than any other game I've played. Really excited for the remake. Let's just have a quick look at the map. Alright, I want to go this way, I think. So yeah, got that finished off. Just need to edit the last episode. And that last episode will be a bit longer than the ones that have been recently. Some of them have been about half an hour recently. The one on the 19th of March will be, I'm not sure how long yet, because it's just the raw footage at the moment, but I'm guessing around an hour long. Just try to be a little bit greedy. Just dodge that shot there. It's down here somewhere. There we go. Yeah, I mean, what I found from me playing this game, at least initially, is you don't want to be too slow. Ooh, this could be dangerous. I think this is one of these, like, lockdown rooms, is it? Containment gate. I'm not sure when I go in here. Do I? Well, that answers that question. Yeah, playing two story can backfire sometimes. Whoa, did not see that coming. Shot me mid jump. Ooh. Oh, I hate these guys as well. Oh, not bloody. This bloody guy. Anyone else? Oh, for God's sake. The troubles of these guys, you need to. That was a quick one. Yeah, I'm starting to think maybe the shotgun is potentially gone from the gun I thought the least of to now potentially being potentially one of the really overpowered ones. Not overpowered, but this gun, crack a swarm, okay. Again, you want to try and mop up these lights as quickly as you can. find that mix of melee and shooting as well. Not the coffins. That's alright, they're fine. There will be enemies that come out of one of them though. At least. I don't know if it's completely random, but... Oh, it must be the last one. Survive a killing blow. Oh well, that is a good drop. Okay, so it must be random because I'm sure every other time I've been in one of those, an enemy has spawned. They're not so there. And okay, can we? Okay, slightly mistimed that. So, can I get over there? Maybe. No, I don't think I can. Oops. So there's a couple of ways we can go. Think. Go this way first. I think this is the correct way to go anyway. There's also a mix of trying to... Where's that? Trying to explore as much as possible so when you get to the Lakes of Pryke, you are upgraded. Ah. Well, that was just terrible. Just for uplights, that was absolutely pointless. Yeah, definitely gonna go for the blaster now. And I like the tracking, so that's a good mix for the... I think that's a good mix for the shotgun, because the shotgun is close range, but the tracker is a bit longer range, so that'll help. Don't get stuck. Okay. Might as well do this. Right, where's that other health? It is... Oh. Yeah, sometimes you can go up to them and select what you want to do, sometimes they just... do that. Okay, okay, so he's pretty tough. It's too bad. They explode on death. Right, I'm gonna take the adrenaline max level. Fair chunk of health there. Big guy, but is it the it's not the King Kong looking guy. Come on. There's a lot of guys here though. I do find that I'm mistiming the overloads on the shotgun because it's not. You can't just hold down with a shotgun, it's individual presses. Right, that was bad timing. Gonna need to hit him though. Get that shield down. He doesn't explode, does he? No. No, we're going to stick with this. That's just the lockdown, that's fine. Right. Don't know if we can get that health. There's potentially some decent here. Got a key, so really need something good out of this. Okay, that's not bad. Health, where's the health? It's up here. Yeah, I don't think I can get that. Get that though. If I don't muck it up. Okay, so, not the best of runs so far. Not good. Use that to get back up. Overload disabled. Okay. Well, considering how bad I've been doing it anyway. Either. Yeah, let's just head this way. No, this is the way we're being, isn't it? I was thinking it was seeming quiet. I mean, my plan was to see if we can kill Frike. I mean, just even being able to get to Frike would be a start. Yes, if you're unfamiliar, anything that's surrounded by that. Oh, crap. Anything that's surrounded by that red sort of orb shield, you have to hit them with. Yeah, just take it. At full integrity, minus 50%. Oh, that's really bad. But anyone with that sort of red shield thing, you have to hit them with the sword to get rid of the shield. And then you can shoot them if needs be. What is my consumable? Creates a shield against the next hit. Do you know what? We'll take it. Because our health's not in the best shape. Got a lot of oblites though. Repairs a major amount of integrity. Breaks yellow barriers. I'm going to take that. The execution rush. So this will, any melee kills will speed up. What else? We have got just over 300. I think we're going to... I think we're going to exchange the oblates. Yeah. Because that's like a sort of permanent thing. Okay, so we've already done that. Oh, crikey. Just failed to get behind the wall there. And of course that's a statue, I forgot they get destroyed. Definitely taking that. So that upgrade I just got really does increase your speed massively. So melee kills are the way to go with the current setup. Okay, so there's health up there. I think we can get up there. Certainly can. And what else is there? Okay, there's something up there. Can easily get to that. In fact, we'll go down here first. Now, something up top as well. We do have an issue that if we go up to full health, our weapons are going to be 50% damage. So, does that show on the status? We need to use keys. Okay. We've got one key. We need to use two keys to get rid of that malfunction. Be great if there was something I could open with a key in here. Ah. Reconstructor. So that's similar to the astronaut, I believe. I don't know if you get reconstructed back here, but that's a lot of ether, and I'm not on the best of runs, so I'm not going to do that. I think that's how it works. I think the astronaut, you pretty much get spawned where you are, and if you use that across your ether, but you then get respawned at that point, like back there in the Wolverine looking thing there. I like how she's happy to just put her hand in things, and you know, she gets what she gets. Okay, so, yes, I took a hit there, but that, gotta remember that that melee kill produces a speed and protection increase is, it's fantastic. Current weapon trait, unlock trait, wide mode. Okay. Right, where's this health? Somewhere up there? Let's get this first. And then let's... looking for a button, there we go. Nope, I'm happy with this gun for now. Right, let's go through here. Please let there be something where I can use a key. I don't think this is it? No. It's a chest, another chest down below. Bonus damage, fire rate. Now again, I still think this is pretty good for what I've got at the moment. I could take that. No, I'm going to take it. I'm going to take it. Yeah, so... collect one more resin, the overload disable will be ended. And there is Golden Gate there. Okay, so I should be going this way, really. So kind of getting further away. Okay. What I might do is... first. No, it's not worth it. Alt fire cooldown, no. Don't want to increase the fire cooldown in the slightest. No, we've got enough malfunctions and stuff at the moment. Unless there's something really decent. Right, let's leave it at that. Can we potentially get up? Where is it? I'm not going to take that risk. I'll tell you what, should we go this Golden Gateway? I just don't think we're in the best run at the moment. I think we need to progress normal doors. Right, there is a teleporter there that we could use. Oh, right, okay, lockdown. Good start. Now, I'm going to have to use melee on him anyway. Well, melee's all well and good, but when you're against the guy that can just take it. Jesus, these guys, man. Slowing me down and there's this big, beefy guy after me. Okay, wasn't too bad. What's this? Nope. Nah, I really like this shotgunny thing, so I'm going to keep that for now. Okay, so let's go through this door. Ah, OK. Okay, it's a key. Okay. This one doesn't require a key. Don't know exactly where it was, but it's around here. There we go. I did see this. Okay. Bad timing by me. Shortens alt fight cooldown. Yeah, I've taken that. And what I think we'll do is gonna teleport. Yeah. Think which is going to be the best way to go. It shouldn't be that way. I'm guessing it's going to be one of these is the right way to go, but I didn't think the ones with the circles above were the right ones. But again, I haven't played enough of a game to know that for certain. So we want to go this way? Yeah. That was poor. This isn't it, is it? No, I think we want to go the other way, actually. I just took that damage for no reason. And again. This way, can I? No, so okay, let's have a quick look at the map. So there's another gateway there. It can't be that. It can't be this way because I don't think I can get to that point. Could be this one, but again, like I say, that's a gateway. That surely shouldn't be it. Not that way. There is a golden gate there. I honestly don't know. It's down. Maybe it is that way. So let's go out of here and then go right. Oh, hang on, what's this? I didn't see this before. Just got enough of lights to get whatever this is. That's good. Because at the moment I am on low health. Yeah, let's keep going this way. Don't rush into this. What am I doing? It's me trying to look at the map at the same time. I'm absolutely terrible. This run is not going well. I mean, I've got that when I'm on really low health, it does increase my... it gradually refills slightly. If I could get up there. I don't think I can. No, I think I tried that before, didn't I? I mean, that's a red door. Oh, that is the way to go, isn't it? And I'm on really low health. This doesn't bode well at all. Still maintain that I don't think I don't think shotgun is the best way to go for the boss at all. And there's just not really any other health anywhere. No. Well, I might as well take it because I don't have any other consumables. Do you know what? I think we're going to have to take this because the shotgun's just not going to do it. Although, the electric blast... That's got bonus damage. No, I'm going to stick with it. So this is the first time we've faced the boss in this run, but our health is so low, there's just, we're not going to survive this. I know we're not. We need to go into this with full health at least. We haven't got the best weapon for the situation. Going to give it a go though, see what we can learn. I think this will be the third time I've faced it. And it's just... learning his moves. Similar to like a, I suppose like a Souls-like game where you have to learn the boss's different attacks and moves in different phases. And I don't think melee's gonna work on him. I should have went with the pistol, shouldn't I? It's just doing no damage at this range. I mean, there's nothing to stop us beating them if we're patient, but the third and second wave is very difficult. And the more time goes on in those phases, just, you know, the more likely you are to die. Time is definitely not your friend. Now, when he does that circle thing, do it without the circle thing. So yeah, when he does that circle thing though, he is about to do a physical attack, like launches himself at you. So you have to dodge. So I've learned that from the last time I played him. Oh, I took a hit there, first hit. Fairly well before that, and I've just done the dodge too early there. We actually made it to the third phase. That's I'm not sure how, but this gets even more difficult, obviously. Jesus Christ, how am I supposed to avoid these? Oh my god, how the hell did I...
The fog has dispersed.
How the hell did I beat him?
The energy signature is gone.
I've faced him, like I say, I've definitely faced him at least twice, maybe three times before that, and I had a couple of times full health, decent-ish weapons. Wow, okay.
A new kind of unlocking mechanism. This could interface with a different kind of translocation device.
Damn. Let me just do that. What's this? Okay. So is this... Does that save up permanently? I'm not sure how that works. Grants 20% stagger for each attached... Ooh. Hatch is a parasite. What parasites have I got though? Is there any way of knowing what parasites I've got? So right at the end of that boss fight, I did actually die as such, but remember I picked up something somewhere, which was a basically revives you upon death, and that's what won it in the end. So we'll go back here. Why have I been going through that every single time when I can just go around the side? I know you can get the weapon, but so I want to go this way. So I wonder if this is going to be, because I've heard people talking about different biomes, I wonder if this is going to get me to the second biome.
The teleportation gate. Based on the coordinates of the broadcast signal, I'm on the other side of the planet.
Hmm. Ooh, additional consumable slot. Permanent upgrade. Unlocked. Oh, okay, so that's how you can go through back to the other side. What's this? Nope, it's just a rift in the space-time or something, I don't know. That's good. Keep going up here, because there seems to be more stuff. Efficiency, that's going up and up, that's good.
I'm in a sprawling desert now, detecting another strange energy from a mountain summit, ascending towards destination.
Again, I still haven't got whatever you can do with that. I'm assuming there's going to be different types of enemies.
Scout log Atra. Beginning ascent of the mountain. I don't know which attempt this is. Despite knowing the hazards ahead, I'm having difficulty retrieving the technology. There are certain obstacles I don't look forward to re-experiencing.
Okay. Okay, so that's health. Void beam. I'm gonna try it. Oh, that's pretty badass. So this is a very open area. Right. If I do try and go over here, what happens? Maybe there's just nothing there. Oh, and there's like dust clouds, so you probably get to a point where you can't. Oh, you guys. What the? Oh, these guys are tough. Of course they are. That weapon is pretty fun. Right. Make sure I get this. Ooh, explosive spit. Explosive spit. Right, let's have a look at the permanent upgrades. Additional, okay. Okay, so it's just those things that I already know of. Projects explode on impact or after a set distance. Right, let's go with that. And potentially get over here. What's this though? Oh, here we go. What? What the?
Encountered armored fauna. Shell seems highly durable.
What is that? It's like a big tortoise looking dude. Aim for the head.
Considerable defense, but dispatched.
So void beam. This has got bonus damage. Okay, let's just try weapons. Oh, I have got the health thing, so let's use the health. Oh, that's really good. We've also got this down here. What the? Well, this was a mistake. That was a big mistake. So you just take repeated damage. You can't dash. No idea about that. Maybe you just have to avoid them for now. Hey, but we got through to the second biome. New simulation mode tier unlocked. Visit ship simulation computer access. Don't think I'm quite ready for challenge tier yet. What equipment I've got so far. Okey-doke. Pick up a parasite, I can then use that to get rid of the parasite and get all blights. Oregon ruins. Wait, if I could get up there. Oh, I can get up there because of the teleporter, but. Oh, did that say reduce melee damage? That's not great. Get over there. There is a teleporter there as well. Is that guy gone? There's anything really up there, is there? No. Let's just go down here. And I'm assuming that was just the teleport that was up there. I've just bypassed it, pretty much. Maybe it was a little bit too aggressive there. Going in with the melee. Let's quickly move in case something happens. Seems like I'm infected. Okay. Okay. That's good. I'll leave you those other two. yeah, I can see you. Is there something going to come out of it? Stop it. Let's avenge it. Being a chicken right now. Oh, those go through. Those go through walls. Alright. What's the deal? Of course they go through walls. Oh, there's a lava pit there. This has been really fun though. I'm probably going to leave this as a fairly short stream today because I've got some things to do, and I might actually do some more. Well, I've got the Resident Evil 4 video coming out at 8 p.m. tonight, which is a premiere, so I'll be on that to watch it live with anyone else watching. I may do another stream later, either on this or another game. I've been playing a little bit of Slay the Spire, which I got on PS5. Really fun game. I might do a bit of streaming on that. That's a little bit more relaxed, a bit of a chilled live stream, so I may jump back on later and do that. But for anyone that's been watching, thank you very much. Obviously the VOD's going to go live on YouTube probably a couple of days after this is live stream. But Love and Returnal, I thought I was pretty sloppy in that run that we actually beat Frike, but we did it, got there. Didn't expect it first time in this stream, so happy with that. And I like the look of the new biome, different enemies, different things to learn. Really, really fun game, difficult, and you know, different every time you play it. But thank you all for watching, and I'll see you soon. Cheers.